Olive and Splash is a line of bamboo athleisure apparel in Burlington. Founder Melanie Wong watched COVID spread across the globe and leapt into action to create a reusable face mask made out of bamboo.
I can remember, going to the manufacturers and saying, I have these orders and I need to make this face mask. And this is during the first lockdown, and it's so eerie. There isn't a single car out on the highway, right? And people are like, we're not working, we're closed. You're a clothing line. You can't make a face mask, that's PPE. And I was like, no, I have all these orders. And so the company that finally stepped up and said, we'll start helping you make your face mask, they brought back just a couple employees, and my face mask was the only mask that was coming off the line in Toronto. And then Dr. Tam had come online and she was like, any mask is better than no mask. And then it blew again, and then within about 2 weeks you would see any label that produces in Canada, they were making face masks as well. And so what went from just our mask coming off the line came from masks being stacked to the top of the roof of these factories, and it was really, really cool to see and to be a part of that and to be able to help out with that.
Recognizing that faces are different sizes and shapes, she's redesigned her mask 10 times with different ear loops and materials. The most recent incarnation was dreamt up as she was jogging on a treadmill.
And it was extremely hard to run full tilt with a mask over my nose and my mouth. I saw there was a lot of complications, and so I thought, how can I design something with three layers that's going to protect us, but still allow the heat to dissipate through the mask as opposed to getting trapped inside, because that's what causes the heat, the bacteria, the fogging of the glasses, all of that kind of stuff. And with trial and error many times, we've been able to create this mask that has exploded into so many other avenues. The asthmatic, the post-traumatic stress disorder, people that suffer from that, we take for granted that we are able to, with healthy lungs, we can wear 3-ply, super thick masks, and there are people that can't. And we need to think about those people as well. And I've had so many families that have come in tears to my window, thanking me that there is now a mask that they can wear because their only option was not to. I've had people with oxygen tanks that come and now they can wear a mask.
Even when face masks are no longer mandated, Wong doesn't see them disappearing.
I think that there's a certain population, a certain percentage of the population that will continue to wear them because they feel much safer, not only for themselves, but for others. Whether you're in close proximity, maybe it's an airplane, maybe it's a restaurant, maybe it's wherever, and they're ill, that they might bring a lightweight, breathable mask with them. This pandemic has psychologically impacted so many people. And it's not even just about, I'm not feeling well, I'm gonna wear a mask today, for the better of the community kind of thing. I think that there's been severe psychological impact. Whether you know somebody that has, unfortunately had COVID, there's an impact there, right? And I see it every day. I see through my drive-through. I see through, people in the community and speaking with them, and the stories they share are pretty serious. Yeah, I don't see it going anywhere.
Reporting for Halton News, I'm Nikki Wesley.